Priyadarshini. She pursued her BE Architecture at Periyar Maniammai College of Technology for Women, Anna University. She secured a third rank in her undergrad at Anna University during the years 2006 to 2011. She also secured the first rank in her college for all semesters, including topper in thesis studies. She then went on to graduate in a diploma in Building Infrastructure Contracts and Real Estate Management from NALSAR University, Hyderabad. She is the recipient of the Pidilite Award for Excellence in Architectural Studies. She is currently working as a design coordinator in Synergy Property Development Services Private Limited, a project management consultancy company with its origin in India, and she also has done projects across the globe with high standards and good project practices. She's also worked on various residential and school projects, mainly focused in and around Chennai.
Welcome to UGC lecture series. Today we are going to see about construction project management. During our earlier lectures, we saw about what is a project, what is project management and their characteristics, and how traditionally the projects were managed. Today we will see about what is critical path method that has been followed now widely, and what is PERT, which we do for research development, all those things, we analyze those things. First we will go about to understand that how to develop a network, and what are the elements that are there that go into the network, and what are their definitions, what are their functions, how to develop the network. First, we will go through what is an activity, what are the types of activities, what are events, what are the network rules that are to be followed, how do we number an event in the formation of a network, and how do we develop a network, how do we calculate the project duration. First, activity. Activity is the basic of to form any network. Activity is nothing but a part of the project which has a duration for it, and it consumes time as well as a resource to the project. Example, laying of a pipe. Laying of a pipe involves a human being that is involved in the project, as well as there is a time that is involved for it, and it has a starting point as well as an ending point. And activities are represented by an arrow with a time and resource description along the arrow. The tail of the arrow, the starting point of the arrow is called as a tail of the arrow, and the ending point of the arrow, that is where we mark the arrow mark, is called as the head of the arrow. The arrow can be a straight line, it can be bent, it cannot be broken. And the arrow need not be drawn to scale, so that like 1 hour and 5 minutes can be to the same length. Length of the arrow does not indicate the time duration of the activity. Normally, activities are of four types: the predecessor activity, the succeeder activity, the concurrent activity, and the dummy activity. Now, we will see what are these four types of activities are. Predecessor activity is nothing but the activity which is done before this particular activity has started. For example, for this activity A, X is a predecessor activity, and successor activity is nothing but activity which is done after this particular activity, which follows this particular activity. So, activity X is a successor for activity A. And concurrent activity are nothing but these two activities can be done simultaneously, they are independent of each other. Say in this network, if you see, A and B are concurrent activities. And dummy activity is nothing but it's an hypothetical activity which doesn't consume any time or any kind of resources here. But this dummy activities are used in the construction of a network because there are few network rules that are there. So, because to fit into those rules, these activities called dummy activities are inserted to make the activity with common starting and finishing point distinguishable. See here, activity A is there, activity B is there. They both have the same starting point, they both start from the activity X and end at the activity Y. So, there is a requirement of a dummy activity here to identify and maintain proper relationship between activities that are not connected by events. This is part of a rules of an activity which we will be seeing later on. To bring all loose ends to a single or initial terminal point in a network. This also we will be seeing in the rules of the network formation. Event. Event is nothing but the where we talked about the head and tail of the activity. No, each head and each tail is called as an event. The beginning and end point of the activity is called as an event, and events are also called as node or connectors. Likewise, the activities are also called as tasks. An event is represented graphically by a numbered circle. Any circle is drawn and it is numbered, that is called as an event. Example of event is like material is procured, design completed, project started, bricklaid. If you notice these things, any particular activity is getting over or either it is getting started. See, material is procured, the activity is completed, whereas procurement is an activity and procured becomes an event. Design is completed, designing is an activity, it is a process, whereas design completed is at completion of an activity, which is an event. Project is getting started, so starting is a start event, and the process of construction is an activity. All activities in a network must commence from some event. Such events are called as tail events. Here, if you see in the bust event, this particular event is called as a tail event and it represented with I, and terminal points are called as a head event. In this merge event, if you see, all the activities come and merge here. So, this is called as an head of an event because it is at the head of an activity. The events are classified into three categories: the merge event, where all the activities comes and merges here; bust event, where the activities starts from here; and there are certain events which acts both as a merge event as well as the bust event. For example, if you see for a merge event, all the activities end towards the project closure. This is a merge event. The closure of a project is a merge event. Bust event, if you see, start of a project. When you have the start of the project, lot of activities start from that particular event. So, that is called as a bust event. All events apart from the start and end events are merge and bust events. They have lot of activities coming to that event and lot of activities are starting from that particular event. So, those are called as merge and bust event. Network rules. As I told, there are few rules that are to be followed when we develop a network, and here are a few. Time flows from left to right. As we all know, we start the network from the right, we proceed it, like as time moves, the network starts flowing and the end is at the right hand side. So, the time flows from left to right. Head events always have higher number than the tail events. Tail events are nothing but the starting point of an activity, and head event is nothing but the ending point of an activity. So, always this activity start event will have a number which is lower, and the head event will have a number which is always higher to the tail event. Simple dependency rule: any event can't occur until all the activities leading to it are completed. Here, if you see, merge event is there. All these activities which come towards the merge event is to be completed, then only this event can start. Likewise, no event can start until the tail event is reached. If you see in the bust event, all the activities 1, 2, 3, all these three arrows can start only after this particular event has been completed. So, this is what it is. And in short, no activity may start until all previous activity in the same chain are completed. That is what we saw now. Logical sequencing and connection of activities. Which activity must be completed before the start of the particular activity? Which activity is to follow? Which activity can go simultaneously? All these things are to be logically reasoned. Depending upon the project to project, these reasoning vary. And depending upon those particular situation, we need to ascertain those logical sequencing and then start our network. There are few errors which are like so happening when we do the rules. So, those are to be avoided. There are a few, like looping. Looping is like activity 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. Activity 4 and 3, if you see, activity 4 starts after the completion of event 3, but activity 3 will start only after event 4 has started. This is not wrong, this is a wrong sense of looping. So, this is wrong. And dangling, there all the network should have only one start event and only one tail, one end event. In between, there should be no hanging of events. Like here, if you see, the 11 is a hanging event. This is wrong. Either it should go to the 10 and stop at 10, or it should continue. There should be only one start event and only one end event for a network. Redundancy is unnecessary dummies. Though dummy does not have any value or any resources or time, we should not keep on using dummies wherever it is not necessary. So, that needs to be taken care of. That type of error where there are lot of dummies are called as redundancy error. Numbering of events. As we stated, when we draw the network depending upon the relationships and all, no, we need to number the events, then only we will be knowing. We can't, in the small circle, we can't keep writing, no, like what is start of the project, internal painting works. We can't keep writing everything in the small circle, and it can't be visible also. So, we try to number the events depending upon the duration it takes and depending upon the timeline where it falls on. So, those numbering, there is a rule that we need to follow for numbering of the event that was devised by Dulbeyray Fulkerson, and this rule is also called as Fulkerson rule, as it was devised by him. Following are the steps that we need to follow. Okay. Say, one is all the projects, as I told, has only one start event that we also can call as initial event. So, the initial event is always called as 1, and After one, you take out the activity, that remove the activity that is coming from one, then this the next circle which is after one will become an empty circle. It can have numerous number of activities merging to it, or it can be even a burst event where there are lot of activities that are going out from this particular event. In this case, it is a burst event where the next circle that is next to one will be named as 2, and then from 2, then all the there are 3 particular different events that are going to happen from after 2 event. So, that can be named either 3, 4, 5 can be named either ways, because after 2 if you remove all these activities, these 3 are there. So, any 3, 4, 5 anyway that can be numbered, and after that and so on that needs to be continued till you reach the end event, and that will be the last event that need to be numbered. An initial event is one which has arrows coming out of it and none of the arrows entering in it, that is the start event. In a network there will be only one such event and we call it one. Deleting all arrows coming from one, this will give us at least one more initial event number, and that is numbered as 2 in this particular network. Deleting all arrows coming from the numbered events, this create new initial events, that is 3, 4, 5 in this case, and they can be numbered anyway. Even if you want to keep y axis as a standard and if you want to number, you can number, or at any random you can number these, and these steps are to be followed until the last event is numbered. So, we know, we have seen about what is an activity, what is dummy, how to create an event, what is an event, and how to number a network, and how to form this network we will just see now. Development of a network. There are 2 ways to develop a network. One is the activities on the arrow or the activities on the node. Activity on the arrow is nothing but, as we represent activity by arrow, we will just mention the name of the activity there itself along with the duration. That is activity on arrow. If you see in this picture, 1 is a node, 2 is a node, 3 is a node, those are nothing but events again, and these arrow marks are nothing but the activities. And if you mention the duration of the activity below the arrow or above the arrow, that becomes the duration of the activity which has been indicated. Activity on node, nothing but instead of leaving the 1, 2, 3 as nodes, you describe the activities on the nodes itself, and arrow marks are nothing but you just join the activities with these things and depending upon the dependencies in which the activities start. For example, there are 4 types of dependencies for any particular activity. Finish to start. Finish to start is nothing but activity A is there and then you have another activity B. Activity B can start only after activity A is completely over with a lag of n days. This is how we represent the lag. Lag is nothing but activity A takes 7 days for completion, then activity B takes another 5 days for completion. But activity B can start only after activity A is getting over, and there is a lag of another 3 days. In that case, that means that like activity B can start only after completion of activity A, that is 7 days plus another lag of 3 days. So, totally after 10 days only this activity B can start, and activity B completes it only after 15 days, that is another 5 days for the duration of activity B to happen. Next dependency is start to start. In this case, activity B and A can start simultaneously if there is no lag, that is n is equal to 0. If there is any lag in that, after start of activity A, after the nth day activity B can start. This is what is start to start relationship. Then finish to finish. Finish to finish is nothing but A and B can end simultaneously if the lag is 0, or as A and B can finish simultaneously with a lag of n days. Say activity A ends on September 2nd and there is a lag of 8 days for the activity B to end. In that case, activity B will end on September 10th. Start to finish. Start to finish is nothing but activity A starting and activity B ending are the same. For example, you have external development works that is being done and filling works are going on. Filling works can get completed and upon completion I can start my plumbing works. So, plumbing works, plumbing in the sense the trenching works and all will start. So, this is like start to finish, the plumbing trench lines will start after my completion of my external filling works. So, this is how it is, start to finish dependency. Development of a network. So, till now we were talking about what is network, how do you need to develop a network and all. So, why did we understand what is an activity, event and all. So, there are few things to develop a network, we need to understand those things, and by developing a network what we do is that we understand the network, we understand the project duration and what are the subdivisions in that particular project are there. So, there are few steps that are involved in drawing a network. Like you break up the entire project into smaller system known as a task. For each task you ascertain the activities and events that are to be performed. For each activity determine the preceding and succeeding activity. For each activity, determine the estimate of the time and the resources that are needed and draw a network dependency and assembly of tasks into the project. So, we will go one by one. Breaking of the entire project into smaller system known as task. It is nothing but you need to construct a house. This is your project. So, what all you need to do? You need to first search for a land, get a land, start your complete your designs, start your construction, and then start your and complete your construction. These are the major tasks that are involved when we want to buy a build a home. So, for each task, ascertain the activities and events to be performed. For example, buying a land. So, buying a land has lot of values. You need to first finalize on the location where you need to buy the land, see 4-5 lands. Like you need to understand what is your requirement and which land suits your requirement, that you need to understand. These are the various activities and events that are involved in particular selection of a land and buying of a land. So, for each activity, determine the preceding and succeeding activities. For example, you select the locality, that is your starting point, starting event for the buying of a land. And then you go around that particular locality, you understand what are the lands that are available for sale, you visit all the lands, you see which is suitable for you, you determine the size which is required for you, and then you buy. These are there is some interdependency in these activities. No, you can't first go as random see lands and then decide upon the location, or at random see the lands and then depend upon finalize on the size of it. So, there is some interdependency on that. That also needs to be understood before we develop any network. And for everything, we need to estimate on the time and the resources that we will be requiring. Before buying of a land can't be a never ending process. Like you want to construct the home within 1 year or so, means that at least your land should be bought 1 month or 2 months earlier. Before we develop a network, we should first list on the activities that are used to be formed in the network. Like here, if you see A, B, C, D, E, F and G are the list of activities for me. And what are the relationship of the activities there? If you see here, C activity will start only after B is getting over. Same way for activity D will start only after my activity B is over, E will start only after B is over, and F will start after E is over, and G will start only after my activity A, D and C, all the three are over. So, here if you see, A and B activity does not have any predecessor. Predecessor nothing but the activity which precedes the activity. So, activity A and B does not have the predecessor, meaning that activity A and B are both start activities and will start from a single starting node, that is we number it as 1. As per Fulkerson rule, that needs to be numbered as 1, and activity A is there and activity B is there, both start at the same time. And activity C, D and E, if you see, all three starts from activity B getting completed. So, activity B gets completed with the node 2. And with this C, D and E, all the three activities start. So, we just draw these arrows, C, D and E are there, and then activity F is there. Activity F gets started only after activity E is getting over. So, activity E is there, starts from node number 2 and it continues here. All these three activities will definitely be having a node, will be getting completed. So, all the three we should draw a event and leave, and it can be numbered anyway. 3, 4, 5 either way. Here we number it as 3, 4 and 5. So, activity E gets completed to activity 5, and next is our last activity, that is nothing but activity G. Activity G will start only after A, D and C, all three are over. So, my A go and completes at node number 4, activity C also go and completes at 4, but activity D go and completes on node number 3. Now, I need to merge these nodes 4 and 3. To merge that, I introduce a dummy, because C and D, they cannot have the same node, starting node and ending node, that is not accepted as per the rules of networking. So, we need to combine merge these two events C and D by introducing of a dummy. Now, I hope you understood why we use dummy activities. And then start the activity G, which has the predecessing of A, C and D, and you have this F which comes after E. So, this F and G now goes and ends into the event, that is 6, that will be the last event of this particular project to get over. Thus, we now have formed one network. We will see one more example for better understanding. Here in this case, if you see, here there are list of activities are from A to J. Activity A does not have a preceding activity, that means that activity A is the starting activity. So, one is the E node that starts activity A and it gets completed to the node 2. From node 2, if you see, A is the preceding activity for three particular events, that is B, C and E. So, all these three events B, C and E will start from after the completion of activity A from the node 2, and all the three events will have individual nodes, and that can be numbered after 2, 3, 4, 5 in any particular way. These three can be interchangeably numbered as per the Fulkerson rules. And then from B you have the activity D that is starting. So, from B you need to draw the arrow activity D, and that will have an end node that is numbered as 6. And then after C you have G that is coming. So, after C you need to draw this G, and that will again have an end node. And then activity H will start activity F. Activity F will start only after B and E are over. So, B is here, E is here, and but this B and E are arising out of the same node, cannot go and join on the same node. So, we introduce again a dummy here, and then you have an activity F that is again coming here. And if you see H, D and F are the merging event, and those starts that before completion of E and D, H can't start. So, F and D comes here to this node 6, and then H event starts. Then you have this I event. I event can start only after completion of J event. So, J event is here, I event is here. G has an end node that is 7, and after completion of this G activity, I activity will start, and it will again have an completion node. And this there is a J activity which will not start only before H and I are completed. So, here if you see H activity is there, and again I activity is there, and J activity will start only after the completion of H and I. Thus, J is the last activity for this project which will have a single node that is ending this project. So, if you see in this network itself, you can understand that every network will have only a single start node and a single end node, and there are various number of activities which are interlinked depending upon the precedence activities that are following it and the succeeding activities which will be following this particular activity. If you see here, H is a successor of activity F and D, that in turn reflects that H can't start before F and H. So, it are interlinked here, all the activity successor and predecessor. Instead of giving here preceding activities, we can even write down the succeeding activities and form a network. And ascertaining the values of duration for each activity, we can come to know about the project duration. This is how it is being done. After you do the network, what you need to do is nothing but to ascertain the time of it. Each activity, as we told, has resources to allotted to it, that it has time, it has the manpower, material, equipment, everything associated to it. So, to calculate the time, we need to first understand the network. After understanding how the network is formed, we need to give activity, all the activity, the time duration that it will take. Here we have four activities A, B, C and D here. So, activity A with, and we will give duration for each activity, so that we can come to the conclusion of the project time duration. Activity A will take 8 days, B will take 6 days, and C will take 4 days, D will take 10 days. Activity A and B are the starting event which does not have any predecessor. So, A and E I have taken bursting from the event 1. And as per the predecessor conditions, activity C can't start once B is completed. So, B will take 6 days to complete. So, C will start from the 7th day onwards. And if you see D is preceding A and C. So, D can't start unless and until activity A and C are completed. Activity A will take 8 days to complete, but activity C will only start on the 7th day and take 4 days. That is nothing but activity C will take 10 days to complete from day 0 of the starting of the project. So, D will start only after 10th day, and D on its own will take another 10 days to complete. So, 10 days for the activities to start and 10 days for this own duration, totally it will take 20 days for this whole project to get completed. Thus, we can arrive at the project durations. So, to summarize on what all we saw today, we just saw about what is an activity, what are the types of activities, that is preceding activity, successor, concurrent and dummy activity, and what is the use of dummy activity, and what is an event, what are the types of event, the merger event, the burst event, both merger and burst event, and what are the rules for to be adopted for forming of a network, how do we number the network using the Fulkerson rules, and how a network is developed based upon the predecessor and successor relationships, and how many activities, all the networks will have only one start event and only one end event. So, how that is being done and how a project time duration has been calculated ascertaining all the activity durations that are linked depending upon the dependencies the project activities have, that has been seen now. So, here are a few questions for you to answer on it. What is activity and the four categories? What is dummy activities and why is it used? What is an event and what are the characteristics of it? What is Falkers and rules and how it is used to number the network? And what are the common errors in network, that is that looping, redundancy and the no end network? And how do you develop a network with the table below using the relationships of the tasks that have been given? Thank you.